Hi, Professor Vishal Lalor. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I teach you constructions and working of Kaplan turbines or propeller turbines. There is a certain difference between Kaplan turbine and propeller turbine that I discuss in this video, and introductions, constructions and working of Kaplan turbines. So first we go through the introductions. The Kaplan turbine was designed by V. Kaplan, engineers from Germany. Okay, so in examinations there is a Pelton, Francis or Kaplan turbine is asked. From out of three, anyone is come in the any examinations. Okay, so first you need to draw the figures and write down the 5 points from the classifications. If you don't know the classification, then go to this I symbol on top right screen of your mobile or laptop. From that you can watch the classifications. Here I discuss this 5 point. First point is that according to the energy inlet. So according to energy inlet, any turbine is classified as impulse or reaction turbine. So this Kaplan turbine is a reaction turbine, means kinetic energy and pressure energy both are supplied at the inlet of turbines. So this the water is the casing of a Kaplan turbines. So water is in from these sides. So at the inlet of this casing, the water have a both the energy, that is kinetic as well as the pressure energy. Second point, according to directions of water supply. That means in which directions of the runner water is supplied. So this is the part of runner. Okay. And this red part is known as a hub. Okay. Now on this is the axis, vertical is axis of the shaft. On this, parallel to the axis of the shaft, water is supplied, that is known as the axial directions. Okay. So during this deciding the directions, we are considered the direction at which water supply to the runner, means at this part. So here it is the radial direction, but on a runner it is supply in axial direction, so it is considered as an axial flow turbine. Third is the at the which head it is used. So it is used for a low head capacity hydropower plant. Fourth point, it is a larger quantity of water is required for a Kaplan turbines. And the fifth point is that it have a high specific speed. So this 5 point is compulsory to return in examinations and draw the figure, and then after explain the construction and working. So next point is the construction and working. Before that, I request to subscribe my channels by pressing subscribe buttons and also press the bell icon to get the continuous notifications. So here we understand the construction and working of a Kaplan turbines. Here you see this is the figure. This figure is indicate the front view, means this upper part is, this is the front view of the Kaplan turbine, and this is the top view of a Kaplan turbine. Okay, and this is the coloring image of this turbine. Okay, so that is a generally 5 parts, and its component is similar as a Francis turbine. So first we know that it is a penstock. From the penstock, water is coming in this scroll casing. Okay. So these two round component is the scroll casing. And when we seeing this top view, it's look like as a scroll part. Okay. So you see here that this area is continuously reducing. Then it is known as the scroll casing. So this part is known as the scroll casing. Then from water from the scroll casing is supplied in the guide vanes. So here this is a guide van. This is also the guide vanes. Okay, because it is a circular component, so we see in the front view, then we looking on the both the sides. Okay, so here you see this is a guide van. There is a number of fan is installed on this guide wheel. Then after water from the guide wheel is supplied into this runner. So this part is our runner. Here you can see this is the runner, and this runner is mount on the shaft. So here it is a vertical component. It is a shaft. This is a shaft axis. Okay, so parallel to this axis, water is supplied into this turbine. Okay, and from the top view we seen, that is here we seen there is a 4 van. This 1, 2, 3, and 4 van. Then after the water is strike to this runner, and then water is discharged to this tail race. Here it is a tail race. Okay, so water from the runner is supplied by using this draft tube. Draft tube means this is a gradually increasing area. It is known as the draft tube. So that is a generally similar components. The difference is that in a Francis turbine there is a 16 to 24 vanes in a runner, but in Kaplan turbine there is a 3 to 8 vanes only. So next we here understands the different another component. The component of Kaplan turbines are similar to that of the Francis turbine. The runner vanes of the Kaplan turbines are adjustable. Hence governing of Kaplan turbine is carried out by governing the guide blade as well as the runner vanes both. Means in the Kaplan turbine, the angle of these runner vanes are adjustable. Here I show you another image. Okay. So these vanes are mounted with this hub. Okay. And this hub have a hollow component. So this van is controlled by the servo motor's mechanism. So this angle is changed. Okay. And guide vane angle is also changed. So in a Kaplan turbine, the governing done by using these two methods. By using the adjusting the guide vane as well as the adjusting the runner guide board. Okay. So Kaplan turbine and propeller turbines are similar, but in a propeller turbine, these runner vanes are not adjustable, then it is known as the propeller turbines. That is the only difference between propeller turbines and Kaplan turbine. Okay, I again repeat that in a propeller turbine, the runner vane angle is not adjustable, but in a Kaplan turbine, the runner vane is adjustable. Next point is that the Kaplan turbine work with the low head. Hence the discharge through the Kaplan turbine is high. Means Kaplan turbine is used for the low head and the discharge means water quantity required is high for a Kaplan turbine. In order to reduce the contact surface of a blade with water frictional resistance, number of runner vanes in Kaplan turbine is limited to 3 to 8 or 3 to 6. Means that is a less number of vanes compared to the Francis turbine. That means it's have a low friction coefficients. If you want to watch the another turbine, Pelton turbine, Francis turbine, then you go to the playlist and also in the description there is a various link is available so you can easily understand the different types of turbines. What is the difference between Francis and Kaplan turbine, that video is already available and governing of the video is already available so you can watch these various videos from the playlist. If you learn something, then like the video. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like, subscribe and share with your friends.